Every year during the fall, my family goes on a camping trip in the mountains. Even though I have to drive 7 hours to get here, I love to look at all of the fall colors and feel the cool breeze. It's the perfect place to unplug. Once you go beyond this point, there's barely any cell phone service and zero internet. Growing up, I never enjoyed coming here. I hated being away from the city. It always felt like I was missing out on exciting things. But now, I appreciate this place for many reasons and find a lot of joy here in the park and in camping itself. Without a screen to distract me, here are a few things I enjoy about completely unplugging on a camping trip. Roasting marshmallows over a warm campfire to enjoy s'mores with my family, and telling stories instead of scrolling. Sleeping in a tent and falling asleep peacefully reading an actual book. Waking up slowly to the sunlight, listening to the soft sounds of leaves or raindrops falling on the tent. And maybe even catch a good laugh first thing in the morning. Thanks, Eric. With no access to a virtual connection with anyone outside of the park, my mind starts to let go of the worries and let the fresh mountain air in my lungs sweep the dust from my mind, and everything starts to become more clear. It really is all so much more simple than we make it out to be. These are the kinds of things I start thinking about here. Doing things outside of my usual routine, like cooking a breakfast over the campfire, forces me to slow down because it takes more focus than pressing a button on a microwave. At home, I barely make time for breakfast. I'll be burning this off on a hike later. Making a conscious effort to unplug from whatever is making too much noise, whether it's our email inboxes, social media, or even people that are toxic, opens up space and clarity to live more at ease and make the changes that we want to see. But just like this hike, doing so takes effort. And I've learned the hard way that if you don't make an effort to slow down and unplug, it's all just a spiral downward towards the life you're actually so worried that you'll end up living. You see, just like the younger me, being afraid that if she disconnected for a little while, that she would miss out, you actually miss out on some pretty amazing things if you don't learn to practice being present now. You can unplug no matter where you are. Go for a walk, no headphones in, just leave your phone in your pocket. You might notice something or someone new. Sit at your desk, close your eyes, and take 3 deep breaths. This one works amazingly well for me. Instead of looking at your phone while you eat, pick up a book or invite a friend over to eat with you. These are just a few very simple things that help me focus on joy instead of fear. You can be anywhere to do them. You don't have to get away. You don't have to be special. You just have to be human. Start small, start simple, Start however you want to, but just start making the effort to unplug more often. The mountains will always be here to teach you to be still and help you reignite the fire of joy again.
I know someday we could finally